There's two ways to approach this. One, you can have Premiere create an automatic transcription for you, which usually is very full of problems, but if you need to get something out quickly, that'll work. Otherwise, like I have here, I have a transcript of the video, and I just got this from whitehouse.gov as an example. And what you do is you bring the video in, and you have a couple ways that you can analyze it. Under the metadata tab, you either click the Analyze button, or you can right-click it and say Analyze Content. Once you do that, you have some options. And what you do is you track down the transcript that you have. Make sure you save that transcript as a UTF-8 and click Open. Once the file opens, it should show you all of the text within it. If you have any missing, then you may not have saved it as UTF-8. And in this case, I'm going to select the box that says that the dialogue matches this text exactly and click OK. And once I've double-checked there, all this is correct, I just click OK. It's going to open up Media Encoder. Media Encoder does its thing, and once Media Encoder is done, you can right-click on the file and select to open the file location, and then you double-click on Temp. And it's this STT-XML file, this file right here. And it'll be the latest sort by date. It's the easiest way to find it. And that's what you're going to bring into Subtitle Edit. Once you've found this file, you can close out of Premiere and close out of Adobe Media Encoder. And we're going to move on to Subtitle Edit. So just make sure you're using the right version of Subtitle Edit. It's version 3.3.12. 0.12 or higher should contain the new Flash Cuepoint capability. So once we've got Subtitle Edit open, we can bring in our XML file, just drag and drop. It's what I find easiest, but you can also search for it by clicking Open File. Once it comes in, you can see you've got a lot of red on here, and Premiere basically does every word, tells you exactly when it fires for closed captioning or for transcription. And what we're going to do is we're going to need to merge those. So go into Tools and select Merge Short Lines. Once this window opens, it's set to 250. I end up usually changing mine to around 400 or something like that, just to really kind of make bigger blocks for myself. But you can leave it, you can make it shorter, you can make it longer, whatever works best for your purpose. After you've done that, you've clicked OK, you'll see that all of your lines, they've really kind of grouped together. I always eliminate all the breaks. I'd been having trouble with some of my WMV files not recognizing the break lines. And so what I do is just select all, Control-A, and click Unbreak. And that will get rid of all those breaks for you, make everything on one single line. Depending on your what you're doing, you may want to leave those breaks in. Once you're done there, you can bring in the video. And you can drag and drop in, or you can click Open Video. Once the video is open, you can click Waveform, and it'll build a waveform, and it'll show you exactly where each of those grouping of words hits as far as the closed caption timing. And then you can just drag and move and edit as you need. It's not perfect, because Premiere every once in a while wants to add, if you have any video with the word with applause in it, you're going to probably see the word the come in. Because Premiere's trying to, or Adobe Media Encoder in this case, is trying to figure out what is being said. So it just throws the word the in there. But a lot of that stuff's easy to find. Like I said, it's not perfect, but it's actually a tool that is very useful when you have a full transcript. Next thing is, once you've decided everything is okay, is you can click Save. And the most popular format, I think, right now is SRT, and they put that right up here at the top. But there's tons of other stuff. Like I said, I use Expression Media Encoder to make my WMVs, and I use the LRC, the Lyric format, because that imports nicely into Microsoft Expression Encoder. But like I said, most people use SRT. And that's about it. I hope this gives everyone an option for doing automatic closed captions to their videos. It's not perfect, but it's way faster than typing the whole thing in yourself. Thanks, and have a good one.